Hello everyone, welcome back to another interesting episode of All About Bridge Engineering. In this episode, we will see the practical applications of the theory of analysis of a simply supported beam in structures around us. So before we jump on to the main content of the episode, let's very briefly recall what a simply supported beam actually is. So through this line diagram, see that a simply supported beam is actually a structural system which is rested upon by two supports at both its ends. At both the supports, vertical reactions are developed. At one of the supports, horizontal reaction is developed, because at the other support, horizontal translation is permitted. In addition to this, no moment is developed at either of these supports because rotation is also permitted. So this was a very brief overview of a simply supported structural form. So in this system, the bridge or the metro viaduct around us today is actually behaving in a simply supported fashion, because you can see that this box girder, this superstructure, is actually a box girder. And on the pier caps, I can very clearly see that four bearings, both at the left and at the right, in total are present. So this means that all the adjoining spans are actually simply supported. So next time you move on the road and come across a bridge, try to figure out the pier cap locations. If there are two bearings on each pier cap in the longitudinal direction, so look at the adjoining span also. If similar fashion is present at the adjoining span, there are high chances that simply supported span is the span in consideration. Nevertheless, it will not be wrong to mention that the theory of analysis of simply supported beam is actually dominating our bridge design industry, because around 70-80% of superstructures around us are actually behaving in a simply supported fashion. It is a different matter that the superstructure may be of different categories. That is, it can be a solid X slab, it can either be a plate girder, as in this case, it can be either a box girder, it can be a girder plus deck slab system. So that is a different matter. But on an average, overall, the structure behaves in a simply supported form. So now let's discuss what loads are actually encountered by this structure. So since it is a metro viaduct, first of all, as always, self weight is the prime load to which every span is subjected. Secondly, superimposed dead loads due to the rail fixtures above this structure, like the rails, the third rail connections, the overhead electric equipment, etc., contribute to superimposed dead loads. So it is very easy to analyze this simply supported structure for these loads, because you don't have to worry much, just you have to calculate the cross-sectional area and multiply it by the unit weight, and you will come with a UDL. You have to analyze the whole structure for a UDL, and at the middle, maximum bending moment WL squared by 8 for those UDLs will be encountered. The problem arises when you have to analyze it for moving metro load. So for that, we have some moving load cases that are very typical, some 4 or 5 types of cases we have studied in our structural analysis systems. So if you have to do it manually, then it can be done, it's not a big deal, but it will take time. And here I again give you that super tip, will like to give you that super tip: start making use of easily available software, that is STAT. In STAT, generating a moving load and analyzing the entire structure, no matter how long the span is basically will not take more than 5 to 6 minutes. And at the end of this episode, I will show you the bending moment diagrams, the envelope of the bending moment diagrams due to moving load. So simply supported structures are basically present all around us. You just have to develop that observation, that vision, to clearly identify which structure is simply supported and which structure is not. Also, let's have a closer look at this. You see that there is a gap between two bearing systems, and this is probably an expansion joint, and hence even deck continuity is not available in this structure. So very briefly, you can see that this is actually a simply supported beam. So on another side, this is a longer span plate girder system, also behaving at a simply supported beam, because you can see that this pier cap is also having two bearings, and the adjoining or the adjacent pier cap is also having two bearings. So there are high chances that it is also a simply supported beam. Another thing to note is that in one frame you are having so many structures. See, this is a plate girder, this is a typical box cutter, and here you see they are rigid portal frames. I have already made a video on rigid portal frames. Check out that if you are interested. So see you again in another video with some new concept. But till then, revise your concepts of a simply supported beam and also enhance your abilities in analysis through softwares. They will definitely help you. So with this closing note, check out the bending moment envelope due to the moving light load and how it is actually generated and start.